October is apple month, and if you can't get out to an orchard, farmers markets are a great place to pick up a bag or a bushel of apples. While apple pie and apple crisp are great staples, today we're making apple sauce. Darren Winfield from Fireside Orchard is here with a great recipe. Darren, thank you for coming.
Thanks, Chris.
Fireside. We talked about this earlier, yes. But is it the chat or is it the variety of apple?
Fireside chat.
That's how it came to be.
Yes, it is.
Okay, very cool. What are we going to do today?
So we're going to make some applesauce. It's really pretty simple. It's something that most people should be able to do at home. And it's a great use for apples that are maybe going to have a better use, like fresh eating or apple pie, whatever it might be.
What type of apples do you like the most for making sauce?
There's a lot of different people that have a lot of different opinions. A lot of people come to our orchard to get Macintosh, Cortland, some older historical apples like that. I like Zestar apples because the flesh has a lot of flavor. Mm-hmm. I'm using Zestar and Regent apples in this one today. Regent is kind of a really apple-y flavored apple, kind of apple intense.
Well described.
Yeah.
All right, first process. The coolest tool in the shed is
so a big part of it is you want to have your apple sizes uniform. We're going to boil these apples down. Yeah. You don't want to have big chunks, little chunks. Some may be cooked, some may not be cooked.
It's like mashed potatoes. More uniform, everything cooks at the same time.
Yeah, so we're just going to use the spiraler and corer that I bought. This is a Regent apple. The nice thing is when you get done with this spiraler,
you know what they say about the kids say about that? It's so satisfying. Watching it spin like that,
yes,
and you
it
hear
is.
It, and it's a great tool. It's one of those classic, well-made tools.
Yeah, and the nice thing is you get these really uniform pieces of apples.
Yeah.
They're all gonna cook together, and they're all gonna be done about the same time. So we've got about 5 or 6 apples
half
in our pan.
Or so.
About 2 pounds of apples is what we started with.
Okay.
We're gonna add 3/4 of a cup of water.
Okay.
And this is just gonna be the medium that's gonna help us heat these apples without burning them.
Is there too much or not enough water when you're making sauce?
Up to your taste.
You could let it simmer longer and release some of that too?
Once you cool the apples off and you start mashing them up, you set these in the fridge and they're actually gonna thicken up a little bit.
I see.
So it may seem like it's a little watery to start, but as you go, it's gonna look a little better.
And how much seasoning for that?
So 1/2 cup of sugar.
Okay.
We've got 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon and just a pinch of salt.
And you like brown sugar?
I like brown sugar. Kind of gives it a little more depth of flavor.
Sure.
Yeah.
So you boil that up. Is it a raging boil? Is it a simmer? What are you doing?
Medium heat. You just want to get it boiling. You just want to cook the apples.
Okay.
All you're going to do. You don't want to burn them. You don't want to just let them sit there in hot water either.
How do you know when it's done?
When you can take your potato masher your fork and whatever, and you can mash through this and get this into the consistency that you want it.
Okay.
I don't want, you know, a complete sauce, but I also don't want big chunks in there. So,
yeah.
So we're going to cover this. We're going to cook this 15 to 20 minutes until it's soft enough that we can mash these up. And then the finished product we made yesterday.
You guys want to try some applesauce?
Go ahead and try that applesauce.
This beautiful pie as well.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. So you talked about the apples that you like, but another good, why make applesauce, right? Well, if you have a bunch of apples and they're bruised or you have whatever issue going on, you can just throw them in the sauce.
They're good.
Go for it, man.
Thanks, man.
Okay, that is really good.
It tastes like applesauce. And it's very simple.
It tastes
like
applesauce.
How long does it last in the fridge, did you say it already?
No. Store it in an airtight container in the fridge for up to 3 days.
Oh, that's got a great consistency.
Yeah. Gosh.
You know
well,
who
thank
loves
you.
This?
I picked right. Yeah.
Kids love this.
Oh, yeah. And it's super easy. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
You know what? It's apple
season.
That's
so delicious.
And we're so lucky we live in Minnesota. Yeah. There's so many. And your orchard is in Northfield.
Yeah. We're just outside of Northfield, right off of Highway 19. Very easy to get there.
Such a beautiful part
outstanding.
Of our
state. And great idea, too.
And that
what's
pie,
up, Bobo?
He bought the pie.
There's a pie here.
In a tub of caramel. Leaving it for us.
Yeah, you've got to try the caramel also.
Oh, that's some really good applesauce. All right. Well, thank you so much. We appreciate
we
the
love
tips.
This.
How many varieties of apples do you guys have at the orchard?
27 different varieties of apples.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay,
my gosh.
Very cool. Well,
all of our apples
what's
have.
What's happening right now, time wise?
So time-wise, these are our big weekends. We've got the St. Olaf and the Carleton Colleges both have their homecoming, so it'll be a packed house today.
Yay!
We grill out on the weekends. We've got a pick-your-own area out there. So, yeah, it's apple season, like you said.
Well, wish you all the best. Yeah, congratulations. We have a link to the Farmer's Market and the Fireside Orchard. It's on KARE11.com for you. All you got to do is text the word recipes to 763-797-7215. You get a link to the recipes page, easy peasy. Apple squeezy, right? Is that what we're doing?
Yeah, something like that.
All right, thanks for being here. We'll be right back.
Thank you.